What's going on, y'all? It's Mitchell Torrance here with Manifest Money Media. Saving money is a topic we talk about a lot on this channel, but today I wanted to give some context and talk specifically about how I saved up my first $100,000 in just a few short years. I truly believe that reaching a 100K net worth is a monumental step in anyone's financial life. So today I want to share with you three steps I took to reach my first 100K and help you realize that it's actually easier than it sounds if you work hard and dedicate yourself to the process. Throughout my YouTube career, I've been very careful with talking specific details about my income, net worth, and investment returns. But I finally came to the realization that if I want to help others reach some of their financial goals like I have, I have to reveal at least some personal information to give myself credibility for the results I've achieved at my age. Now, I'm not going to reveal how much my net worth is currently or tell you how long ago I reached the $100,000 mark, but I will tell you that these three steps are the actual way that I got to my first 100K. And just for context, when I say 100K, I don't actually mean $100,000 in cash sitting in a safe somewhere. I'm talking about a $100,000 net worth, which is your assets minus your liabilities. So without further ado, let's start with the first step, which is to create a gap between your income and your expenses. So no matter if you're a medical surgeon or you work in a warehouse, if your income is more than your expenses, you will save money. It's called math. During the time it took me to save my first 100K, I was only making anywhere from 50 to 70,000 US dollars per year. Now, depending on where you live in the world, this might sound like a lot of money, but here in the US, this is pretty much smack dab in the middle class, where in 2018, the median household income was about $60,000 per year. Now, my income wasn't anything spectacular, and it was enough to where I never struggled financially as a single guy, but the important thing was that I kept my expenses to only $20,000 or $30,000 per year. I was very conscious about unnecessary spending, and unlike most Americans, rarely blew my money on dumb shit. But even during those 3 years, I took multiple international vacations, visited friends and family in different US states, and still managed to have some amazing splurges and experiences here in Nashville. That's because travel and experiences add a ton of value and joy to my life, and I decided that these were the things that I would actually splurge on. Coupled with new credit card churning and some creative travel hacks, I was able to travel for much cheaper or almost entirely free. Now, depending on if you have kids, what your income is, and a host of other variables, you'll have to sort of manipulate this math equation for your personal situation. But it's really pretty simple math. You make 100 a year and you live on 60, you'll save 40. You make 40 and live on 25, you'll save 15. Figure out some financial goals that are reasonable and sustainable within your budget, and you'll see how simple creating this gap actually is. To wrap up this step, I'll leave you with a quote from the multimillionaire business mogul Robert Kiyosaki. It's not about how much money you make, it's about how much money you keep. The second step to your first 100K is to invest into assets. Once you've created a difference between your income and your expenses, you'll have some money left over to start investing. The best part about you saving your first 100K is that the next 100K will come much easier. This is because the money that you earned previously will now start to make money for you. People who own stocks, real estate, businesses, and other investments make money in their sleep due to dividends, appreciation in value, and cash flow. To reach the 100K mark faster, I personally invested into things like my Roth IRA, mutual funds, and index funds. I also would sign up for new bank accounts, leave a minimum of $10,000 to $25,000 in there for a set period of time, and then receive a one-time bonus of several hundred dollars for meeting their requirements. I also chose to invest in myself, whether that was through education, learning new skills, or buying things that would allow me to grow my business. Now, one thing I wish I had done before my first 100K was when I had enough money for a strong down payment, invested into real estate, find some roommates, and have them pay down my mortgage. I know it seems like having cash laying around is like having an extra layer of security, but trust me when I say that it is very unlikely that you'll ever retire if you never put your money to work for you. So put your money into assets that will grow over time, leave them alone, and rake in the returns. Do keep an emergency fund of 3 to 6 months of expenses at all times, but park that money in a high-yield savings account to earn at least some interest. And for most situations, if you have consumer debt besides your mortgage, I'd recommend paying those off first before you start investing. Finally, the last step to reaching your first 100K is to stay consistent. Now, I already know that this is the step that no one wants to hear about because I'm sure you've seen the ads everywhere to make millions fast through network marketing, a sketchy self-proclaimed real estate guru, or my personal favorite, investing in BitConnect. While there may be a small handful of extreme winners that randomly pick an exceptional underdog to win big, there are millions of others who aren't so lucky that lose big. Maybe you've got a crystal ball and you can magically pick the next revolutionary startup, which in that case, give me the crystal ball. Just hand it over. It's no surprise that even Warren Buffett says that you can almost never beat the market and that consistently investing in a total market index is pretty much the best decision that you can make in the stock market. Staying consistent involves your daily lifestyle choices. Do you really need to have 3 specialty cocktails every night that you go out? Or would you rather choose to have a few drinks at home and then buy 1 nice cocktail when you go out? Would you rather have the newest and most expensive car right now or a lifetime of wealth and freedom later? Do you have the self-control to skip going out to eat for a couple of months so that you can buy your first house hack where other people will pay your mortgage? Your daily choices completely dictate your future, from the food you buy, to your rent or mortgage payment, to what type of clothes you wear. So just remember that every daily decision has an impact on your future, and to also include at least some money in your budget for fun, eating out, vacation, or your hobbies, so that you stay consistent with the rest of your finances. Thanks so much for watching, y'all, and I'll catch you on the next video.